Hi guys, welcome to the Lawster, Lawsomely Awesome Lawyers. So I am here to present the series of lectures on Constitution of India. This series is presented and conceptualized by me. My name is Shreya Deshpande. I am a law graduate. In this video, I am going to cover the part of Introduction to Constitution of India, and in more videos, I will be covering the part of Introduction to Constitution of India and the syllabus of the Constitution of India. So let's begin. What is the Constitution of India? How it actually came into existence? What were the reasons and circumstances behind the making of this huge and written document like our Constitution? Our Constitution is the lengthiest document and it is written. This makes our Constitution a unique constitution among all other constitutions in the world. For thorough understanding of this Constitution, please do watch the whole series of the lectures. History of Constitution of India. The source of this lecture is a book by an author, Subhash Kashyap, named Our Constitution. So Dharma was the concept. Dharma was the supreme authority which controlled the people, governed the people and united the people. We can see enough evidences which show that the republican forms of government, representative deliberative bodies and local self-government institutions existed in many parts of ancient India. After the period of Mahabharata particularly, large empires gave a way to number of small republic states. For an example, Jatakas was a kind of republican state that existed in ancient India. And more of this context can be recalled through history. So if you want to know more about these kind of institutions, you can read books or you can even watch videos. The Greek scholar Megasthenes has left records of popular assemblies that were preserved in the south and which restrained the power of the kings. So you can certainly imagine the position of the king. The king had actually become a constitutional monarch or a limited monarch. And he could not do anything on his own wish and will. Whatever he had to do, he had to take a recourse to the opinion of the people. Kautilya's Arthashastra has also recorded that autocracy or the divine right of king had no place in ancient Indian polity. And Nitisara, The Science of Polity of Shukracharya, written in the 10th century, is a book on constitution that deals with the organization of the central government and also the village and town life of the king's council and of various departments of the government. The king was to act on the opinion of the majority of the people. Now coming to the British rule, how the company was formed, how East India Company came into existence. The company was formed by some of the merchants of London, which secured from Queen Elizabeth a royal charter granting the company monopoly rights for an initial period of 15 years. The charter also laid down the constitution, powers and privileges of the company. Later, the powers and privileges were subsequently enlarged by the charters. By the year of 1700, the company had established its factories, that is trading centers and chief settlements at Bombay, Calcutta and Madras. These were called as the presidency towns because the chief business or the main functions of the company were handled through these presidency towns. By the charter of 1669, the island and port of Bombay were entrusted to the company at an annual rent of £10. The company was also given the power to make necessary laws and issue ordinances for the good government of Bombay and its residents. Hence, subsequently, the company had acquired the authority to rule over a definite territory. So, it was for the first time that the company had become a ruler from a mere trading company. It was also subsequently given the powers to issue its own coins. The Charter of 1863, the company was empowered to declare war and enter into treaties, subject to the provisions that the company could not assume sovereign powers over any territory. Because the company was a mere representative of the British Crown, and so it could not do anything on its own wish and will, it could not declare any war or enter into treaties, because it was subjected to the provisions that the company could not assume sovereign powers. The Charter of 1726 empowered the governors in council of three presidencies at Bombay, Madras and Calcutta to make bylaws, rules and ordinances in conformity with English laws and subject to approval by the Court of Directors. So if the Court of Directors did not approve these bylaws, rules or ordinances, they could not come into operation. Later, the company took the advantage of the weakening central authority, the disintegration of Mughal Empire, and disturbed conditions all over the country after Aurangzeb's death. The company emerged as a dominant power. The company also won the Battle of Plassey in 1757 against Siraj-ud-Daulah, Nawab of Bengal. And this all clinched the issue and foundations of the British rule were laid in India. Later, the company also won the Battle of Buxar against the combined forces of Mughal Emperor Shah Alam and Nawabs of Awadh and Bengal, which gave the company the territory of Bihar and Orissa. The company was also vested with the powers, or the company had also acquired the full powers of land revenue collection and the administration of civil justice. But the responsibility of administration and maintenance of law and criminal justice remained with the Nawab. But these all situations, these all trials did not prove to be fruitful. They all proved to be very much disastrous, and that led to the appointment of an inquiry committee by the British House of Commons. The committee recommended the need of regulating the activities of the company, and the result was Regulating Act of 1773. The Regulating Act of 1773 and the further part I have covered in the next videos. So please do watch the next videos for more understanding. So thank you for watching this video. Watch more videos of this series for better understanding of this subject. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more awesomely awesome videos. For more updates, stay connected to our Facebook page, that is www.facebook.com/awesomelylawster. Thank you for watching. Thank you.